What's up, you guys? Welcome to today's video. As you can tell by the title, we're going to be talking about prison commissary. I'm going to break down what everything cost in prison from my handy dandy commissary sheet that was sent to me from my friend Jason in federal prison. We're going to talk about how much money an inmate needs when they first get to prison, how much money they need monthly, and how much money it would be to barely survive prison or be living an okay life in prison. I'm also going to be calling some of my friends that are also prison YouTubers just to see what their opinion on it is. I definitely have one opinion and I've calculated everything that I would need when I first get to prison. I also wanted to make this video because if you're a prison pen pal and you're sending money to a friend in prison or a family member in prison, I feel like it's just good to know what items cost and what you need. And I wanna make sure that you guys are not being taken advantage of. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. So I have calculated here everything that I would need when I first go to prison, and then everything I would need for my hygiene for monthly maintenance, and then monthly maintenance needs plus some food items that I would need as well. Now, when I was doing time in prison, I never had anyone send me money. Well, maybe a friend here and there, but that was so limited, so I had to hustle to get things. Now, I know a lot of people think, oh, if you're in prison, they're feeding you 3 meals a day, you're good. You need so many items in prison. That's all they give you, is 3 trays 3 times a day, and an outfit, and a towel, and some blankets. You know, you really don't have anything. You don't have hygiene products. You don't have an extra t-shirt sometimes. Sometimes prisons give you long johns, like thermals, sometimes they don't. So what do you sleep in? When you first get to prison, if they don't give you thermals or long johns, you sleep in your prison outfit, which is like the most uncomfortable scrubs ever. And while I do understand that prison's not supposed to be like the freaking Holiday Inn, there are things that you need in order to survive. So that is what we're gonna break down today. Now, I have all of my prices calculated, but I wanted to call some of my friends to see what they thought you need. So if you were to go to prison right now and I had to send Christina some dollars, how many dollars would she need?
I would personally say $200 to start with. Now that may seem like a lot to some people, but you're gonna wanna get tennis shoes. The tennis shoes they give you, or they don't give you tennis shoes. They don't give you tennis shoes. The shoes that they give you are absolutely awful, and you can buy tennis shoes off the canteen, which they're like $60, they're very expensive. And then of course you're gonna wanna, you know, rack up on all your hygiene items, your female tampons. You know, regardless, you're gonna need your shampoo and conditioner if they sell it, and just little items and stuff that you'll need. And then from then on out, it'll be a certain amount, but, and obviously all of those are luxury items. You know, if you weren't getting luxury, I would say at least $50 so you can get your hygiene items, because that's the most important thing. I'd rather starve as long as I don't stink. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and like, you get hurt if you stink. You have to have good hygiene. Hygiene is above all else in prison.
Yes.
So one more question and then I'll let you go. I know you're so busy. How much money do you think you need just for like your monthly maintenance, and then how much money would you need to like be living a decent life?
I would say the money that you absolutely need is at least $50 or $60 a month for hygiene. That's what I think. That's with nothing really any extra. That's hygiene, maybe a soda every now and then. To be living decently, I mean, just decently, not balling in there, I would say $30 a week would be really nice. But that's like being able to cook with your friends all the time. That's being able to help others out. There are people that get in the max is $100 a week. That's a lot of money. But, you know, nobody needs that. But $30 a week would be really comfortable. I got, I believe, $60 a month. And that was mostly hygiene. And then I would have when I got that money, I would get like one little weekend where I could make food and share food and then make soup stretch. And $60 a month, I was grateful for, but it would have been nice to have more, but it's all good. You know, I'm in prison.
Literally. Okay. Well, I love you. Thank you so much.
Love you too.
Bye.
Bye, everybody.
Okay. Yo tengo una pregunta.
Okay.
How much money do you need when you first get to prison, in your opinion? And talk loud.
Well, that depends on what you're going to buy if you're going to get all your stuff, or if you're going to be like broke.
Yeah. So how much money, like, to get your stuff?
So the necessary stuff that you need right away when you get there is, you know, hygiene, stamps, because you're going to start writing to everybody asking for money. You know, stamps, hygiene, and your homeboys will probably give you a pair of sneakers and some old jogging pants, so you'll be fine.
Girls don't do that. Girls don't do that, bro.
No?
No.
Oh, well. Thank God I was part of a gang then. Being part of a gang, when I get there, they give me everything new. They give me a care package with shoes, jogging pants, food, and a little bit of, a little bit of weed.
Oh, wow.
Celebrate, because I just got there.
Okay, so if you're brand new, how much?
I'd say about at least $100. $100 will take you a long way.
Okay, and how much do you need monthly to survive?
You should be able to survive if you're not gambling or doing drugs. Like, you should be able to survive on $40 just fine, a month.
Yeah, so I think men and women are just different. I had different needs. I would need a little bit more, but that's pretty close to what I say.
Well, yeah, I mean, because men, all that you really need is, you know, shampoo, some deodorant, and you know, a couple of soups, and you're making it because you make everything work.
Yeah.
I mean, I survived for a year when I was in the RDAP program just with the $24 that I got paid from working in the laundromat.
That's federal, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Never had the chance to go to the feds. Okay, say bye to everyone. Thank you.
Later.
Heads up, I'm going to be talking about just the feds.
Well, that's what I got here. I have the Fed commissary sheet. Okay, so, Jonathan, prison life inside and out. What would you say you need the day, like day one in prison, your first week in prison, how much money do you need?
I have two separate answers, and the reason why is because you have your, I want to be a baller, have everything that I could possibly need, and then you've got just what you need to get by.
Me.
The two different answers are going to be 150, and that would be just to get the stuff that you actually need. You need yourself a set of sweats. You're going to need yourself some food. You're going to need your toiletries, deodorant, toothbrush, blah, blah, blah. But in the feds, you have a spending limit of $320. It used to be $290, but they upped it. And if you want to do it all the way and have absolutely everything you need to hold $320, because in federal, they have MP3 players, and those bad boys are about $70. And you can buy songs, which are anywhere from $1 to $1.25 a piece.
So how much would you need, like, to survive monthly?
I would say on a monthly basis, about $100, $150. And again, it does depend on how you live, because some people buy Taster's Choice coffee, some people buy Keefe, and there's a huge difference in the cost.
There is a huge...
Taster's Choice is $7 a bag, Keefe is $3.
There's a huge difference there's a huge difference in taste. It's funny you say that, because on the new Fed sheet, I don't see Keefe on this commissary sheet. I only see Folgers.
Oh yeah, they got that Folgers, but I never liked it because it's really fine. And dark colored, you know that difference. It's not granulated like the Keefe is.
Yeah. So monthly, yeah. Like 150, you'd say.
Yeah, because I mean, you don't need excess stuff after you get your initial bump. After you get your MP3 and your sweats and your shoes and all of that, you shouldn't need any of that stuff again for at least a year.
Yeah. Okay, I agree. Say bye to everyone. Thank you so much.
Peace.
Bye. So, I made my commissary list of everything that I think that you need, and I also have all of the prices. And now this is a federal form that I have. These prices are gonna be a little bit different. So there's only one thing that I substituted, and that's a radio. So in federal prisons now, you have, like Jonathan said, you have MP3 players, and they cost anywhere from, he said $70, that's pretty close. On this sheet it says $88. So day one in prison, what you're going to need is shower shoes. And in the feds, they're charging almost $7 for shower shoes. So $6.95 for like some janky flip-flops. You're gonna need soap, shampoo, and conditioner, fingernail clippers, a pen, paper, and stamps, sweatpants, which are $20, an extra t-shirt, which is $5, a washcloth, a radio, a mirror, a soap dish, a bowl with a lid, and chapstick. Those were like my necessities. I am mildly addicted to chapstick. So that was my necessities. So for hygiene, it would be the shampoo and conditioner, which I just mentioned, deodorant, toothpaste, a bar of soap. So when I totaled all of that up, the hygiene plus all the things that you just need, it came to $8,240. Now, that's out the gate. So $100 is a really good estimate, but that's not for the feds. If you want to get a radio in the feds, which is now an MP3 player, that's $88. So we would bump that up to $200 if the person is in a federal prison day one. Now, I marked a radio down for $28 because that was like one of the radios I had in the last prison that I was at. They had indigent radios. Now, if you have no money, all prisons give you around $12, $15 a month indigent in order to get hygiene items. That is just a given set amount of money and you can only buy hygiene items with that. But there was a radio on indigent and it was like this big and it was terrible. So there was a $12 indigent radio, which anyone could buy. Then there was the $28 radio and then there was the $50 radio. So I know that's changed and every facility is different, but if it is just a state facility and your loved one or family member is going to prison and they're brand new, don't have anything, I would send at least $100 so that they could get set up. I didn't even include sneakers on this list. Sneakers would be an extra $60. So minimum they need $100. If you wanna make sure they have sneakers because, oh my God, those flats really hurt your feet after a while. And if you're working 12-hour days and you're wearing these awful flat shoes that they give you, your feet are gonna hurt. So I would send the minimum of $100, but $165 so that they can get the sneakers as well. And they're Nikes or New Balance and you can take them home with you. So if you were like me, I didn't have anything, I would take them to the street also once I'm done with my bid. So then how much money do you need monthly to survive in prison? If it's just hygiene items monthly, you're going to need about $15 every 2 weeks. So that does equal out to be $30 a month just for hygiene items. Now, Suave shampoo and Suave conditioner cost $1.90. Deodorant costs $2.70. Toothpaste costs $3. A bar soap costs $1.70. Pen costs $2 on this Fed sheet. I don't know if it's like the rubbery pens that you can't use or if that's an actual pen, but on this commissary sheet, a pen is $2. So now if you want your loved one to be able to have hygiene as well as eat, bare minimum, it would be $13 a week. And now this is why I say bare minimum, because soups, ramen noodles, cost 25 cents. I would get at least 15 soups a week. You can just have an extra soup. They're cheap and you're not gonna be starving. And then I would also get coffee. So that would be like the bare minimum plus your hygiene. So Christina's guess for $30 a week is pretty spot on when you add in the hygiene and the food. That's pretty good. Now, I would tack on an extra $20 a week if you want your loved one to actually be able to eat. So something that I would get if I had $50 a week, which is like, I mean, I could really make that work and I would be able to save money too, probably. I would get refried beans, which are $2, brown rice, $1, sausage, summer sausage, which is cooked. Then I would get chips. On top of the soups that I already got, I could take my bowl with lid, which we have to get, and I could make these little spreads. And if you guys want me to make that recipe for you, just in a bowl, you know, like those rice bowls or whatever, I could totally make that for you guys. If you want to see that, just let me know in the comment section down below. I would take one soup, I would take chips, refried beans, the brown rice, the summer sausage, and the chips, or like cheese puffs. And I would mix them all together and cook them in a bowl and you're gonna get your own individual spread. So again, if you wanna see that recipe, let me know down below. And I wouldn't make that every night, I would have to stretch that out. So I didn't have money, I didn't have anyone that was sending me money. So what I had to do is I would have to braid hair, do eyebrows. I was really good at legal material. I was also really good at getting contraband. I made straws for people out of the thermostat covers in medical. I would steal them from medical. I would take real pens from staff members. I would take gum. Anything that you can get that is contraband or they don't sell it on commissary, that's a high value item. I don't recommend doing that, but that is why it's so important that if you have a loved one in prison, they do need some money so that they're not breaking the rules, so that they're not having to hustle or even extort or fight for food. You know, just to recap, what do I think you need day one in prison? $100 to $150. What do I think you need every single month? 50, 60 bucks a month would, you know, just kind of be getting by. $90 a month, that person is really able to create meals, have their hygiene, be able to write you, and they're living pretty comfortably. I know so many people don't have an extra $100 a month to give to their loved one in prison. So there are ways that people can hustle to get food, whether it's art. Art is a very valuable commodity in prison. Or like I just said about the contraband, but I don't recommend that to anyone that is going to prison. Don't do that. Just follow the rules and find legit hustles that you can do, like threading eyebrows or braiding hair or just doing makeup for people. There's so many different things that you can do in prison to try to get a little bit of extra money, which is paid to you in the form of commissary on commissary day. Prison is not easy. You know, you have to be able to take care of yourself and survive. Prison is really rough, but I want to make sure that if you guys have a pen pal, you know what things actually cost and what a person actually needs. If you guys have any questions that I didn't answer in this video, let me know in the comment section down below and I will do my best to answer them. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was useful. I hope it was informative. Hope it gives you guys some insight. Stay safe, stay sober, do not break the law, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Editor, did you feed the fish today?
I did, yes. Oh. You caught me right in the bathroom.
Ew, are you pooping?
No, I'm just playing.
I've been waiting on you. I did not go to town because I was waiting on you.
So you're so southern. I didn't go to town because I was waiting for you.